Thank you. Open up!
I'm out!
Cover me!
Contact! You're two on the top floor!
See ya!
Great shot!
Grab that cover, Corporal! I want you to take your heels in here and hold!
You got it! What the f***? How's it to raise your game? Do you understand? Louder! I like it. Pick it up. Burn, as Jack Burton said, it's all in the reflexes. Hands out. Come on. Too slow on the floor. Give me 20. Too slow on the floor. Give me 20. Oh, nice work. Nice work. Back to your desk. You too. Carry on.
What do you think about Phil Mellor motivating the team?
I think it's a great idea. Phil's a real people person.
This pie's are for closers only!
Are you sure?
Yeah, he'll go really well. He's got a fantastic rapport with the QA guys.
You're not trained to be merciful. Mercy's for the weak. It's not good enough. Boom!
Aaron, I think Phil got a bit carried away.
I don't understand.
Broken monitor, I've got mince pies which are scraping off walls. I've been dealing with HR. Nick said Phil will be fine. This is absolutely insane. I don't get it. I mean, we've got half the QA lining up to quit. You know what? We damn well better beat the USA now going through all this kind of stuff, because this is absolutely insane. It's ridiculous.
Sunny Wilsworth, team boundary, starting off with Wayne. Wayne, how are you today?
I'm fine.
What do you do here at Boundary 42?
I'm on the QA team, as far as the QA tactic.
I've seen you in practice today. You have been picking and taking numbers.
Yeah, especially in the race.
You set a personal best today.
I did, just over 30 seconds.
Nice, very nice. Look forward to seeing you on the track shortly.
Excellent.
And now to Mickey Oliver. Oh. Mickey Oliver, we've seen you on ATV a few times.
Yes.
Are you? What is your highlight you're looking forward to today?
I'm looking forward to starting.
Perfect.
Yes.
Favorite weapon?
I like the shot.
Okay. Yes. Get up close and personal.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Andy Nicholson. Nice to see you again. How's the ship balancing going?
Oh, it's great.
Are you enjoying the playthroughs today and getting a lot of personal feedback on your own balancing? Now over from our German office, over from Frankfurt, we have Melissa. Melissa, how are you today? Any message you want to give our community?
Thanks for supporting us.
Wonderful. And Mark White.
Yes, hello.
What are you flying in the race coming up?
I'll be in the 350R. 350,
okay. Are you expecting to come in the top three?
I'm hopeful.
I saw you come first and second in early playthroughs.
Yeah, that was
mainly.
I go slow.
Okay, slow and steady. All right. Well, this is Cameron Wilkie from Wilmslow, heading back over to Allen.
Listen up. You had the honor of being chosen to be part of this team. Now I see potential, and I, for one, did not come all the way out here to go home a loser. Did you?
No, sir!
I don't believe you!
No, sir!
Then you will train. You will need to hone your mind and your body. Winning isn't just an option. It is the only possible outcome. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir!
I can't hear you!
Yes, sir!
Sudden salutation! Straighten up that chakra! Toby, straighten up that cord! Alright! Let's get some wheatgrass.
Is that everything?
Yeah, why?
I thought we were supposed to be doing a montage.
I don't know.
None of us have time, and that's why we were doing the montage.
Did you guys see my chicken wings? There's a bunch in the fridge.
Question, why don't you tell them who you're at and then you can run over to the left and tell them you're at and see how you're doing.
It was tough and it was exhausting, but I think it was well worth it.
All right, fantastic. Let's move on here. Now, Colby Schneider, I saw you take a little bit of a fall in that video a second ago. How? No, you didn't? That didn't happen? Okay. Well, how was it working with Steve Bender this week?
It was great. He was really inspirational, and he got us to be our best. So,
all right, fantastic. And the wonderful, well, I'll let you introduce yourself. Steve, the camera right there.
Hey, I'm Michael Blackard. I'm with the ATX crew, and I am a QA tester.
Now, was Bender a little too intense for you, or how'd it go?
No, Bender was extremely enlightening. In fact, if I win this for the team, he's going to teach me how to make his tri-tip.
Did he pay you to talk good about him?
No, tri-tip is enough.
Bender, let's move on. Same question, who are you and what do you do for Cloud Imperium Games?
I'm Matt Sherman, technical designer here at the LA offices, in spaceships.
Fantastic. And how do you see the outcome of this tournament going?
Well, today...
You better say that USA is going to win.
Oh, no, I'm just going to ruin Texas' reputation because I'm playing this.
Okay. I'm okay with that. All right, awesome. Thank you. And last but definitely not least, your name and what you do for Cloud Imperium Games.
Pietro QA.
All right, and working with Steve Bender, you know, whole training throughout the whole week, how'd that go? And is Team USA going to take this entire thing? That's what I'd like to hear. Let's jump back to Jared Huckabee.
All right, Ben. Thanks, Ben. We're returning to the race, already in progress. Right off the bat, we have a last-minute substitution. Matt Sherman is taking the place of Vince Sinatra, Mayo Fumato, on Team USA. So while it still says Mayo Fumato in his name, that is, of course, Matt Sherman, who's in sixth place right now. Come on, Matt. You can do better.
Now, do you think that's an advantage? Matt's a designer. Vince was a QA. Who do you think has the edge here?
I don't know. Did Matt work on the design of
I'm not sure, but I do know that Vince played a lot, so we'll see how that affects the
now,
team.
Now, here we see who's in first place. This is Wayne Owen from Manchester United Kingdom. He's on Team Europe. He does have face paint. I didn't notice that before. Wayne is one of our senior QA testers there in the Manchester office, and he is just dominating on the racetrack right now. So we're going to take a look now at Andrew Hernando go from one of our most dominant to one of our newbies.
He is brand new. You know, I noticed during training it looked like he was exploring the maps instead of racing.
Yes.
He can't hear me, right?
No, he will. Okay, we will almost certainly see Andrew who's exploring the maps later on. Andrew has only been with the company for 6 weeks at this point. So now let's take a look at Tyler Tumlinson. Now, Tyler works out of our Austin studio.
Yes, Austin, Texas studio. Actually sits right behind me. Really awesome guy. I'm super happy that he was able to come out and compete in this.
And look at what he's flying. He's flying the brand new 85X.
Yes, it is sexy.
He's having trouble making that turn. Oh, let's check in again with our friends in the UK. We're still on Wayne Owen here. Wayne Owen's still in first place. Oh, but now here's Melissa Estrada in seventh place.
Now, this is actually really surprising. Melissa Estrada, I've known her for a few years, and she always flies the Origin M50. And even throughout training, she was flying the M50. So seeing her in the 85X here is an interesting choice.
Gotcha. Now we're just following. What is this? This is a Mustang Gamma making a leisurely tour through the map here. We'll go on to check out Colby here. Oh, Colby hit the race ring. Not so good. Switch back to Matt Sherman here. Now, Matt Sherman's in seventh place. Guys, as we explained before, this match is for 25 points. We have a weighted point system. We'll be playing the first event, which is racing, for 25 points. We'll be playing the second event, which is dogfighting, for 25 points. And then we will be playing four rounds of Starmering, which will all be worth 25 points apiece.
Wait, now hold on. That's an even number. So what happens if we tie?
Well, if we tie, there will be a sudden death overtime match of Starmering for all the marbles.
I kind of hope it comes to that.
Yeah, so do I. Let's check back in with the UK here. There's Wayne Owen again, first place. He's just has Wayne seen another player?
Oh, it looks like he missed the ring, though. Now's their chance to pass.
Come on, Wayne. Team Europe.
No.
For the purposes of this broadcast, I'm Team Europe.
You just like the outfit.
All right, we're going to follow Wayne going through the race tunnel here. Oh, he's on his third lap, so this is actually the finish for Wayne.
Yeah,
let's watch
sure
Wayne
is.
Win the race. Oh, what a
show-off. Off with a decoupled roll.
What a show-off with a decoupled roll.
And that is it.
And that's it.
I'm going to go ahead and mark this down. First match, Europe, 25 points. Okay. Yo.
Nice little graphic for Team Europe winning. Let's play that right now.
Oh, yeah.
Let's take a look here
right
now. There we go. All right. So we have players starting their positions. They haven't engaged yet. They are just, they're in the feeling out.
All right, Team USA. Don't let me down.
Here's Matt Sherman filling in for Vinny Sinatra, who went down with a terrible stomach bug. Vinny, we're all thinking about you. All right, he's looking for target there. Whoa! Yeah. Obviously, he's discovering that new afterburner system, which is dangerous in a map like Dying Star with all of these asteroids. So he's got his missile lock. Is he going to do anything with it?
Probably get a little bit closer.
All right, let's check in with a member of our UK team here. Here is Melissa Estrada herself. Oh, and there's Mickey. Mickey, you may remember from from Around the Verse.
Yeah, I know. She's hosted quite a few of them now.
Actually, did you know that Mickey actually hosted Around the Verse for the first time her second week with the company?
Are you serious?
Yep. Yeah. So she's there. She's trying to get missile lock. There's a missile cam. And... oh, looks like somebody knows how to use
her. Fun fact about her, she's actually closely embedded with the character art team. Helps them a lot.
Yes, she does. All right, now we're going to check in with Colby, Mr. Meantime himself here at QA in the LA office here.
Just take a moment to appreciate his face. That is a game face.
He is engaged with Andrew Maudsley. Now, Colby is flying a Hornet Wildfire, and it looks like Andrew Maudsley is being chased in his Avenger Renegade.
Oh, we got to see a little glimpse of the new pickups that are in patch 2.6.
But Colby, look at the look on his face. Andrew Nicholson took out Colby. He does not look happy about that. Let's check in on New Blood here. Andrew Hernando found one of the fuel replenishments. Now, one of the
he's
things
actually
that
getting
separates,
in there.
Yeah, he is. One of the things that separates Arena Commander from life in the persistent universe is the gamified nature. This is a game within a game, so it has lots of pickups that you can get after you've dispatched one of your enemies.
Perfect.
You can
see
on the screen now. You can see ammo pickups,
ammo repair.
Repair pickups, missile pickups, all kinds of things which are necessary to remain effective inside a game like Arena Commander.
Absolutely.
So we'll check in one more time with the UK.
I'm proud of Melissa Estrada. He's really getting in there.
Yeah, he's getting better.
Melissa Estrada actually was in the Austin, Texas studio for a long time. We worked really close together on the QA team. Now she's in the Frankfurt studio working very close with the engine team. She's very good at our editor.
And looks like she's got somebody.
Oh,
in fact, she's just
looks
stalking
like ProSol. That's Eric Pietro in the LA studio, another QA tester.
Bubba Weave, Eric!
And she is sharp there.
She's just picking him off one after another. Come on.
I think she's disabled his ship, too. Either that or he needs to learn to fly.
So let's check in again with Andrew Hernando here. He's got Idris in his sights here. Now, Idris is a member of our Manchester team.
I can't say it enough. I am proud of him. I mean, we keep cutting to him, and he is right in the action. I expected him to hang back. I mean, he's new.
Yep, and he's always tracking down those power-ups.
He really is. He's utilizing the pickups.
He got so many power-ups, we can't even tell what he got. Missiles, repair. Good job, newbie.
It kind of pains me to say this, but let's talk score real quick. Right now, Team USA at 11,435. Team Europe over 6,000 ahead with 17,600 and climbing.
Team Europe. Let's check in on one of our observer cameras here. Here is a lovely
Avenger
Renegade. Off on a leisurely stroll throughout Dying Star here.
No, also, the VFX for the thrusters in the back are also new to patch 2.6.
Oh, yes, they are. Good call. Let's check in once again with our UK staff. Here's Andrew Nicholson. Now, Andrew Nicholson started life as a QA tester.
He did. He actually was leading QA in the UK, but he moved on, and now he is a designer.
Now he's a designer.
Recently responsible for the key bindings overhaul we had, so please send your complaints there if you have any. Not us. Just kidding. Love you,
looks
Andy.
Looks like he's having a close encounter with that asteroid.
Glad
we got that on
camera.
Sorry, Andrew. Sorry, Andrew. Let's check in one more time with Matt Sherman here. Matt Sherman subbing in for Vinny Sinatra.
He is stone-faced and focused.
Now, Tyler, once again, you know what they're playing for. They're playing for nothing short of immortality.
Well, and 25 points. Don't forget that.
Well, the 25 points are heading towards their immortality to get for their chance to have their name emblazoned on the RSI Cup awarded to all of our backers for displaying in their hangars for all time.
Absolutely. So we've got just over 15 minutes left. Team Europe is still holding that around 6,000 point lead, but that's nothing. I mean, we've seen 6,000 points change in the matter of 30 seconds. It just matters on if they're really getting in there or not.
Let's check in one more time with our UK team. Here's Mickey Oliver one more time. She just evaded a missile. Fantastic job, Mickey.
Now, if there was a prize for grabbing the most pickups, Andrew would be in first place right now.
Yes. Now, Andrew Hanna has been doing a fantastic job picking up the prizes. Now, we're following Melissa Estrada right now, and I have a fun fact here. It says Melissa Estrada is obsessed with cats, and her life's ambition is to hug every cat in the world.
Do you know where that phrase came from? I want to hug every cat in the world. That was actually from the first episode of Witch Glitch that we did. I introduced them all. She sat to my right, and she was supposed to say a one-liner, and she said she wanted to hug all the cats in the world.
Oh, and she just took out Underscore. Now, Underscore...
And immediately grabbed the pickups, too.
Underscore might be known to folks. Underscore was a member of the community who recently
sure
joined the team.
Mr. Bryce Benton. He's also my roommate, unfortunately. I mean, he's also my roommate, period. Great guy. Absolutely great guy. He actually works really close with the DevOps team. He's being trained by Jeffrey Pease, does a lot of stability work, focuses on crashes, and works with the engineers.
Right now we're following Tyler Tomlinson as he is stalking Wayne Owens. He had Steve Brennan in his sights before, but he decided that he found a more attractive target.
Oh, come on.
Come on, Tyler. This is your chance. Team Europe is running away with
Lights
this thing.
Lights on you.
But the missile's not enough.
Nope. Sure
but
isn't.
The missile's not enough.
No, right, he's on it. He's got his gimbals locked. He's moving in. Missile locked.
All right, we'll check in one more time with the UK here. Here's Wayne Owens.
Look at that face. That is some Braveheart stuff.
Yeah, he definitely has that fantastic fantastic
it's
focus.
It's intimidating.
Face. He is stalking meantime our own Colby Snyder here in the LA office. I wonder if Colby even knows he's there. Let's check in on Colby and see what Colby's doing. Nope. Colby's not even aware he's there. Colby is tracking his own target, has no idea Wayne is behind him. Just picking up. Oh, no, they're actually in Justin now. He's found Wayne now.
Looks like Mickey just died in the background.
Is it Colby or Wayne? Who's going to win this dog fight here?
Yeah, and it looks like Team Europe has even grown their lead up by about 7. Oh, no, more than that, about 10,000 right now. Just over 13 minutes.
Let's check it on this Gladys Valiant. Gladys Valiant's looking for somebody to fight. Oh, but he's down a wing. That's unfortunate.
Oh! That was perfect. That was a perfect cut.
That was Mr. Wayne Owen.
Absolutely.
I would check in one more time with Matt Sherman.
That looks like it was the Hornet Ghost that we were on a moment ago.
Matt Sherman tracking down Andrew Maudsley one more time. He's saying, I've got a Saber. You've got an Avenger. Matt, I'm sure Matt feels like he has the advantage right now.
Oh, he's getting in there. You see the VFX on those cannons also new to patch 2.6. I really like them.
Mm-hmm. Checking one more time with Tyler Tomlinson. Tyler Tomlinson, he's tracking down Shamaros. Shamaros. Shamaros is our own Ray Warner out of the UK.
Why does your team have some complicated names? We're just like Tyler, Colby.
And we have a fun fact for Ray Warner. He says he bangs his head against the wall to burn 150 calories an hour. We'll see if that's a...
That makes a lot of sense when you talk to him. That makes a lot of sense.
I'll check in once more time with the UK here. We have Andrew Nicholson. He's on Pro Salt's tail again.
I love the face paint. He's got the UK on his cheeks and Frankfurt on the forehead.
Well, this is a unified Team Europe effort.
This is an international competition.
So ProSalt can't do anything to shake Andrew Nicholson. Andrew Nicholson is just on him like white on rice, which is not to say, you know, any insult to those lovers of brown rice. Yeah, they're not all going to be winners. You don't have to look at me like that, Tyler.
I'm sorry. Yeah, they can't see me looking at you like, what?
I'm sure they can feel you looking at me like that.
Well, they're doing the same thing. They're all looking at you like that, too.
Oh, and he went head-to-head with ProSalt, and Andrew came out on top, even if he did it the hard way. Let's check in one more time with Colby Snyder here. Colby Snyder has got Andrew Nicholson in his sights. I'm thinking he wants payback.
No, I think he got him.
Okay.
And he's picking up those ammo pickups.
So one more time, Team Europe has the lead in the entire competition. They are up 25 points, but Team USA is closing the gap.
Yeah,
on this
they really are, actually. Just noticing that right now. It's about a little under 5,000. Points are going up fast, though, so there's a lot of combat taking place right now.
Colby has decided to show up. He is doing some massive damage.
The gap just closed a lot. We're within 3,000 points of each other right now. Come on, Team USA. I believe.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, matches in Arena Commander end when one of two conditions are met. When either the time limit counts down or the winning team reaches a total score of 60,000 points?
I believe that is correct, yes.
All right. So we are just about halfway through this match.
Yeah, in both avenues, yeah.
See, you said I don't know math.
Well, you know what? Occasionally, what's the saying? A broken clock is right twice a day.
And so am I.
Or is it once a day?
All right, so we're checking in with Melissa Estrada here. Melissa Estrada is looking for somebody to kill. Looks like she's found Underscore. You got any words of encouragement for Underscore?
No, not at all. I am fixated on the score right now because Team USA is just over 2,000 points behind. It looks like they may actually catch up.
Switching to Andrew Hernando here and his Avenger. He has got Idris in his sights. There is a lot going on around that one asteroid.
Idris. Not an actual Idris. Oh, that would be epic.
I wonder if he gets that a lot.
Probably.
Sorry, Idris. Let's see if that's mentioned.
Dude, look at Andrew go! I'm super impressed right now.
Idris's fun fact is that he sometimes gets mistaken for Mark White.
I think that Team Europe heard me warning them about Team USA catching up because they have started to largen. What's the word for that?
Widen the margin.
Widen the margin. There you go. Thank you. This is what I have to do.
Let's check back in one more time with the UK feed. Here's Mickey Oliver in her own Avenger. She's got underscore in her sights. Underscore seems to be attracting a lot of Team Europe's attention. You can do it, underscore.
You know, it's rumored that underscore is one of the better pilots in the Austin office, so we'll see if you can pull this through for him.
Do I have a fun fact for underscore?
For underscore?
Yes, it says his pastime is watching football, and his obsession with Star Citizen led him to joining our team. Also, he's a trained yo-yo judge.
I'll just tell you right now, you don't need to read anything. I can tell you all of his most embarrassing secrets, but I'll save that.
All right, with that, let's check in one more time on Matt Sherman, our own Matt Sherman, technical designer out of the Los Angeles studio. Subbing in for our own Vinny Sinatra, who went down with a stomach bug. Survives this mid-air collision. Lives to fight another day. Who's he got in his sights right now? He's got a glare on his screen. I can't read it.
Oh, it's Idris again.
Oh, he's got Idris.
Yeah, so we have just over 8 minutes left. Team Europe is ahead by just under 9,000 points. It's going to be potentially close.
Team Europe pulling farther.
They are,
away,
but
man.
I'm not giving up yet, okay? I'm still believing in Team USA.
All right, we're going to check in one more time with newbie Andrew Hernando.
I think Andrew's going to take it home.
You know, he heard us, you know, talking about him in rehearsal, I think. He probably went home last night.
Yes, we were talking
spent
a lot
all
of crap.
Night practice.
We were talking a lot of crap
all
in rehearsal.
Night practicing, because when we were practicing before, Andrew was taking a scenic tour of the Dying Star map. No, maybe he was doing that to throw people off, though.
Yeah.
Lower expectations so we come in and surprise everybody. We'll check in one more time now with Tyler Tomlinson. Tyler Tomlinson got Shamaros one more time in his sights.
Yeah.
But does he have any missiles left to use?
He sure does. It's looking like this is getting very close to being over, with Team Europe less than 5,000 points away from winning round two, earning themselves another 25 points, putting them at 50-0. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. There's still time.
Do we know how to pick them or what? Checking one more time with our own Colby Snyder here.
Up.
Colby Snyder's picking up a wealth of rewards here.
Team USA needs to be focusing right now on combat. Do not just get points from kills, you also get points for damaging.
And we'll take a look at the UK feed here. We've got Andrew Nicholson. Andrew Nicholson's got Colby in his sights. We have a fun fact about Andrew Nicholson. It says, Jared, I don't like fun facts. Bite me.
Wow. All right.
Thanks for your fun fact there, Andrew Nicholson. That's really helpful.
That was very reflective of his real personality, too.
Yeah, that's what you get. See the look on his face right after he died.
Less than 4,000 away from finishing round two, Team Europe. Well, at least we'll get to see Cameron again. Yep.
Melissa Estrada, after our own Andrew Hernando there. I think she's realized he's a bigger threat than she thought, than we all thought. All right, we are on the last kill of the match, guys. One more kill, and the game is won.
Yep. That's it again. Team Europe has done it in round.
That's winner, Team Europe. So the game is starting. And here we are.
All right, Team USA, let's make up for the Aerospace Expo right now.
So right now we are following Matt Sherman here on the United States team.
Now, Matt Sherman works a lot on ships, so I'm hoping he has done some practicing.
Now, he's chosen to break off from the group.
That was the new vault animation that he hopped over as well. But, I'm okay with him breaking off from the group if they fan out and get those capture points, you know.
I don't know about that. Let's check in with Andrew Hernando. I see Andrew Hernando staying with our own Tyler Tomlinson here. They've chosen to assault their control point together in numbers.
Yeah, I prefer to think the buddy system is ideal here.
Oh, but Michael
Blacker, yes. Fun fact about Michael Blackard, he's a veteran console player who acts as our gamepad testing expert for Squadron 42 and the Austin studio.
Did you see that? Newbie just took out Andrew Nicholson. Andrew Nicholson didn't even see it coming.
Well, yeah, Andrew Nicholson was Team Europe, though. It was well-deserved, right?
He's got that laser rifle.
Oh, Andrew's trying to hack.
Oh, he's trying to hack, but he's under fire.
This is where the buddy system comes into play.
That so important what you just did right there. Andrew broke off from the terminal.
Right here, look at this.
Let Matt Sherman get the cap. Went away and then used a heal. Now,
yes,
you can bleed out in this
covering.
Game. It's one of the most important mechanics that you have to manage in Star Marine.
Oh, I don't know how many times I've seen that. Somebody gets into a firefight, they win, they go to hack the terminal, they bleed out mid-hack. You have to heal.
Yep, you have
I
to
mean,
heal.
It's crucial. That Andrew oh, with the use of a grenade!
Andrew Nicholson got newbie back
that
with a grenade.
That was amazing.
Let's check in on the UK right now. There's Wayne Owen.
Wayne Owen, first place in the race. Let's see how he is in FPS.
Wayne Owen is a particularly dark section of the map there. He's got his flashlight on.
He's being much more strategical.
So he's playing the waiting game. Camping is a legitimate strategy. Let's check in now with Colby. Colby just met Andrew Nicholson, too, and Andrew Nicholson just took him to school,
Colby
dropped him off
quit.
At the corner, and didn't even pack him a lunch.
Wow. Did you just make that up? Did you just make that up? That was... I don't know if I like that or not.
It's better than the brown rice one, though, isn't it?
No, yes. I'll give you that much. Now, Tyler Tomlinson, I know, does a lot of testing on Star Marine as well in the Austin, Texas studio.
All right, so
curious
Tyler
what his
here.
Weapon of choice is.
It looks
here.
Like he's taken to the zero
to
G.
Oh,
but this is the EVA. And he is using the shortcut to go to control point B. So right now control points are pretty. Oh.
Yeah. Now, Team Europe has the lead with three control points. Team USA with only one. Team USA 59 points. Team Europe 92.
And there's Tyler with the heal. So important in a match like this. Right, checking in one more time with Matt Sherman here, subbing in for Vinny Sinatra.
And you see in the bottom left corner, it looks like he is injured right now, so I don't know if he has any heals left.
And worth pointing out, Team Europe is ahead in this match because once again, they are owning the control points. Team Europe with three control points.
No, you know
Team
what?
USA with only one control point. They're not going to win
this can't
match.
I can't even argue
point.
It. It's true.
They're not going to win this match with only one control point. Andrew Nando. Now Andrew Nando has switched from the laser rifle to his bearing.
Yes,
and
the
Wayne
ballistic
Owen
rifle.
Made him pay for it.
P4AR. That's my weapon of choice.
Checking one more time with the UK team. Here's
Mickey
Oliver.
Another with the heal.
You gotta manage those heals.
I love the new radar as well. It's coming in 2.6.
Oh, but killed while reloading. That
heal did her no good.
That is never any good.
What's
going on here? Now look, Team Europe is. Looks like they've captured all four control points. Oh, nope, they've only captured three. The readout here is actually incorrect. We will switch to Tyler Tomlinson here.
Now that camera that we just saw was actually the free cam that is going to be available in patch 2.6.
Mm-hmm. And Tyler Tomlinson seeing a control point, but he's got folks coming.
Oh, grenade out! No! He's someone that got him from behind.
Oh, they exchange grenades. Melissa Estrada with
that
another grenade.
That is brutal.
Let's check in on Colby Snyder, Mr. Meantime himself. Where are you going, Colby? You going to hack control point D? Is that where you're going?
I think he's just going to hide at this point, because right now Team Europe is up by over 100 points.
Colby definitely playing it safe, checking the corners.
About 2.5 minutes left on the clock. This is round 1 of 4.
Nice work.
Well, it could be over a lot sooner than that if Europe keeps this up, though. Steve Brennan taking Colby out.
Checking with Andrew Nando.
Control point lost.
Telling you, this guy's growing on me. He's getting
good.
So Andrew falling behind a teammate here. There's a number of teammates being close proximity to control point C. Let's see if they bother capturing it.
Oh, getting the ammo refill. Smart. Andrew seems to really utilize the environment with the pickups in the squadron battle. Now the ammo box is here. Oh, grenade out. The grenades are coming back in return, though.
Oh, but he got Melissa with
he
it.
He did. He sure did. The grenade landed right at Melissa Estrada's feet.
Let's check in with the UK team again. Here's Andrew Nicholson. Now look at this, Team Europe about to
look at their coordination. Like I know I'm Team USA, but their coordination—they have two people, one checking left, one checking right. Andy on the control point. I mean, that's how you win.
Team Europe came into this competition ready to play.
They did.
So Andrew Nicholson going around saying, "I have all the
control
points."
And this is just about over yet. I mean,
what is there left for me to do?
Team Europe at 230-ish points with three control points, while Team USA only has one control point at 113 points. under 2 minutes left, but I don't think we're going to make it until the timer runs out this time.
Now they just got to decide, do they want to go for the four cap? Andrew's falling behind Steve Brennan. They're approaching hack point A. With this point, they can go for the four cap and add insult to injury.
And it looks like they took it, and you know what this means, right? More awkward Cameron with Cameron.
Nice work.
I love you, Cameron. Now remember, this is an international competition, so we're dealing with a stream setup that is very, very complicated. So a little bit of delays.
So here's Matt Sherman, who's falling in behind Tyler Tomlinson. They approach control point D. Better heal, Matt.
Now straight back into round
Matt,
two.
Matt, you have to heal. Matt has chosen not to heal, and you can see his screen coloring out. Matt was going to die. There was absolutely no way to avoid that. If he hadn't been shot at the end, he would have bled out.
So now that round one is over, that does award another 25 points to Team Europe. So it is currently 75-0.
Yep.
Now, you know what that means. If Team Europe wins this round, that's it. It's all over.
Yep. So round one completed. We move directly into round two. No time lost. But Team USA is taking those capture points seriously now. They've already got one. They're capturing their second. They have now split the control points.
Waldo Marine.
Sticking our own Tyler Tomlinson. Oh.
Now, if you heard in your headset, you heard that. Well done, Marine.
Yep. Now, Tyler Tomlinson is going to bleed out. He better heal. He's focusing on grenades. He's trying to play offensive. But
yeah, he is bleeding right now. He needs to heal. If Tyler doesn't heal, he is going to die. Yeah, he is. He is bleeding out.
Looking for a health pack.
Oh no, oh no.
A health pack.
He's desperately trying to find something. You see the colors, he's losing color in his screen as he bleeds out. This is vicious. We're just watching this guy bleed. I feel like I should go over there and hug him or something.
That's right. We'll check in on the UK team here. We have Melissa Estrada.
She looks like she's on defense right now, holding down point D.
Well, one of her teammates went into that room and paid the
price. Oh, point C, actually. Yeah, see, this is smart, the defense.
Yes, they're playing much more tactically now. They've decided to hold on to their points and try to make the other team come to them.
They got the points first, got a small lead, and they're just holding them. It seems like they're not even going for the third point, unless they have a flanker.
Checking with our own Colby Snyder here. Colby, where are you going, man? He sees two of his teammates ahead. It looks like he's going to meet up with them.
All right, sticking with two and
ahead.
We
have four members of Team USA in close proximity to Terminal C. Let's see if they go forward and actually
try to capture. Fun fact about who he's following, Tuna Head, that's actually Don Allen. He's another tester who focuses on the PU. But most notably, he's been focusing on our demos that we've been doing for CitizenCon and for Gamescom and all of that jazz. Really awesome guy in the awesome studio.
See, we see Team USA here. They are sticking together, tight formation. Moving from one room to the next, they are trying to approach point C.
It's not a huge gap right now. Team USA at 96, Team Europe at 128. Both teams have two control points and about 3.5 minutes left. And remember, if Europe takes this round, that's it. They also take home the RSI Cup.
Let's check in with our UK team here. Here's Wayne Owen. Oh, he fell in behind a teammate.
Grenades
into rooms now. You never know. You know, it's called fishing. Sometimes you catch them.
Yeah.
Sometimes you don't. I don't.
Nope. That's not true. I've seen you in some of the FPS playtests. You're pretty good.
Yeah, I was talking about actual
fishing. Why did I just compliment you? I must be tired.
You must be very, very tired. We switch back to Tyler Tomlinson here just as he got a kill on Shem. Wow.
Hey, I just want to point something out right now. Team USA has all four control points. They just took the lead for the first time in this entire tournament. Oh, just over 2 minutes. If they can defend,
control point lost.
Yeah. Things are going to change.
So much for the Kavork.
I'm going to get to walk over there and talk to him. This is great. But Team Europe has taken back two of the control points, but that is okay. As long as, I'm going to say this loud so they can hear me. As long as Team USA holds two control points, you will win this round.
All right, switching over to the UK now, looking at Mickey Oliver here.
I don't know how this happened.
Ran afoul of Michael CIG. Here's Andrew Nicholson.
This game is neck and neck, 145 to 143, 2.5 minutes left.
Go
The importance of this game for Team USA is huge for both teams, really.
Andrew Nicholson has realized that Team USA has decided to play the capture game now.
Yeah, they're moving a bit quicker, a little less strategy. They might be a little worried.
He knows there's a player at control point D. He knows there's somebody there capping right now, so there's a kill waiting for him.
And Team USA is widening the margin, yet, as you would say.
Actually, you were going to say it. I gave the words.
Oh.
I wouldn't have said it.
You suck.
All right, so now they've split the control points. They've split the control points, but the damage is done.
It is. Team USA is in the lead. As long as they hold those 2 points, if I were them, I would split up the team 5 and 5, 5 at each control point. I would hold it, and I would take this win.
Now, Tyler CIG just became an ace. Hey, Tyler. Our own Tyler. What does becoming an ace mean?
Becoming an ace means it's similar to a killing spree in other games. You got 5 kills without dying. So Tyler Tumlinson over there, QA tester from the Austin office, is what they say, on fire. And they are defending these points well.
Respawning.
There's less than a minute left. I think they're going to pull this off.
Nope. All they got to do is hang on to
Team Europe has to do something now.
What are you doing?
Or never.
He's trying to melee him, but bullets will do. Andrew Hernando with another kill on Melissa Estrada.
Oh no, Team Europe is taking one of the control points. And Andrew's going to save it. Andrew may have just had a game-winning play, stopping Steve Brennan from taking a control point. Just over 30 seconds left. That's going to be it.
Andrew, the
3 points for victory.
Hernando puzzled us all in our
That's it.
That's
Andrew
it.
Hernando
that's
has
it.
Won it. Team USA has won round two. We're going to jump right back into round three, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. So we still got some time to go.
25 points for USA.
We are on round three. Now, right now, the score is Team Europe with 75 points.
Team USA
with 25
points. The thing is, if Team USA wins this round and the final fourth round, we're going to have a tie game, and we're going to have to go into a tiebreaker.
Yeah, but they got to win the next. In order for Team USA to
Hold
win
on.
This,
I feel like you're about to talk some crap.
Rounds. Team USA's got to win 3 rounds in a row.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Right off the bat, Team Europe has a short lead, but it's way too early.
Matt Sherman is bleeding out.
Nice work.
Matt got Andrew Nicholson, but chose to go mano a mano without
Come on, Team USA, you need to get C. Team Europe's taking C. They're going to get an early lead, and if they hold it, that's going to be it.
We're now following MVP of Team USA, I think.
Seriously, Andrew Hernando, where did this come from? So Team USA only has one control point. A lot of grenade use going in there.
Here's Melissa. Now, Melissa's obviously taking a healthy amount of damage here.
You know, I've noticed a trend with Melissa, though. It seems like she's always on the defense. She's really focusing on her strategy. I'm wondering if they had assigned a buddy system before this, because it seems like a lot of the pairs are consistent.
Mm-hmm.
UK has come prepared.
Now, folks watching at home may wonder where you've seen Melissa before. Melissa was one of our outlaw characters in our Gamescom demo.
Yes.
Specifically, she was the one that took the brunt of that freelancer fire and went flying way up into the air.
She was, the one who drove the rover and did that thing over and over as well. Or you may have recognized her from Witch Glitch.
Yep. Matt Sherman went head-to-head with Andrew Nicholson, and Andrew Nicholson said, I got face bullets for you.
Absolutely. So right now, just over 5 minutes, if nothing changes right now, then Team Europe is going to take it and be the champions of the RSI Cup.
Tyler Tumlinson, he's approaching control point B. Not meeting any resistance, but did find a friendly face. Two friendly faces up ahead. So now he falls behind. There is safety in numbers in a game like this.
Oh, absolutely.
Unless those numbers are on top of the grenade.
I love the amount. A lot of good grenades being thrown.
Oh, he threw a grenade, but it bounced
and
off
it's
the
rattling
ground.
Right next to him.
But he was smart enough to get away. Good job, Tyler. Other Tyler, I'm not talking about you.
Listen.
All right, we'll switch into Andrew Nicholson here.
Perfect heal. He almost bled out.
Took a lot of damage there.
He did.
But luckily, he had his med pack.
He's still. Look at these grenades. They're basically playing catch right now. Oh, here we go.
Oh, caught reloading. That is the worst.
I don't think that he has any heals left. I'm pretty sure Andrew Nicholson's going to bleed out.
He just used his health
pack.
Yeah,
he is bleeding out right now, so his best decision right now is to rush. And this is another. And he bled out.
He bled out.
Again, though, the importance of knowing when to heal. I mean, he needed to use it earlier, so, I mean, that's the best he could do in the situation.
Now we're following Wayne Owen from Team Europe. Team Europe, by the way, in the lead. commanding three control points.
Yep, they have held it since the beginning of the match. I'm telling you, their strategy with defense is taking this. This is a cool look at the new bar.
Checking the score, he wants to see how far ahead he actually is. Yeah. It's a player with confidence. Using the EVA system, I don't know where he's going, so we'll go to Vince here. Vince just took out, you know, Idris. Of course, I say Vince, but this is still
it's not, yeah, sure. It says Mayo Famato, but...
Yes, and again, if you're just joining us, Vinny Sinatra, a member of Team USA, went down this morning with a terrible stomach bug. So
yes,
Vince, we're thinking
Vince
about
if you're watching this from bed right now, we love you, man. Get better, and we'll see you on Monday.
And honestly, on behalf of Team Europe, I'm glad you're not in the match.
Yeah, honestly, that really was the most upset. Well, no. Most upsetting part to me is he's not feeling well, but he was definitely the ace in our pocket.
Oh, Wayne Owen made Matt Sherman pay for it. All right, so here we are with Tyler Tomlinson.
Yes, put some hearts in chat for Vince. Thank you.
Yes, everybody, press F in chat.
Because you know he's watching
F's,
right now.
F's in chat.
F's in hearts.
All right, Tyler and Melissa going head to head.
Just ripping into Melissa Estrada. She is down.
Fighting for a control point.
I got to tell you, though, right now, 84 to 219, this is a huge gap.
Team USA would have to play on a Jared level.
They would need to take
to pull this out.
Oh, shut up, you. They would need to take all four control points, but right now I'm feeling like people in Europe are already starting to pop the champagne bottles because it looks like this is just about over.
It's Matt Sherman checking out all the beauty and splendor that Echo 11 has to offer.
Yeah, this is going to be it. I don't think there's a way at this point. 7 points away. So let's go ahead and give an early congratulations. You're real proud, aren't you?
Yeah.
You're real proud, aren't you?
And that. So now, congratulations to that. See you. Yep. Final.
from our team. Happy holidays to you guys, and we'll see you in 2947.